Welcome to the province of Abra. Meaning of the official seal of Abra, from the Spanish word abre, meaning gorge, pass, breach, or opening, and it was first used by the Spaniards to denote the region above the Banaong Gap where Abra River exits into the China Sea. Thus, the Rio Grande de Abra, later it was used to name the newly created province drained by its great basin. Twin peaks on both sides of a river denotes the region above the Banaong Gap where the Abra River exits into the China Sea. Prancing stallion, it means that Abra was once upon a time famous for its horses, noted for their strength, speed, and endurance. Padded fields signify that the main occupation and means of livelihood of the people of Abra is farming. The history of Abra. Abra was originally called El Abra de Vigan, meaning the opening of Vigan. Abra was first inhabited by the ancestors of the Bontocs and the Ifugaos and the Tingnans or Itnegs. In 1818, the Ilocos region, including Abra, was divided into Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur. In 1846, Abra was created as a political military province with Lepanto as a sub-province. It remained so until the arrival of the Americans in 1899. In 1908, the Philippine Commission once again in annex Abra to Ilocos Sur in an attempt to resolve Abra's financial difficulties. On March 9, 1917, the Philippine Assembly re-established Abra as a province. In 1942, the Japanese forces occupied the Philippines and entered Abra. Abra was liberated by the Philippine Commonwealth forces and local Cordilleran guerrillas during the Battle of Abra in 1945. At the end of the Second World War, the revolutionary Marxist priest Conrado Balueg, who fought for the rights of the Cordillera tribes, began his crusades in Abra. After successfully negotiating a peace accord with Balueg's group in 1987, the Philippine government created the Cordillera Administrative Region, which includes Abra.
Abra Province Geography. Abra Province is one of the provinces in the Cordillera Administrative Region in Luzon and its capital is Bangued. Abra Province in northern Luzon is located in the Cordillera's central mountain range which separates it from Cagayan Province and the municipality of Bontoc. Mount Province. Abra is landlocked by Ilocos Norte in the northwest, by Ilocos Sur in the southwest, Kalinga and the Payao provinces in the east, and Mountain Province in the southeast. Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur belong to Region 1, which is the Ilocos region, while Kalinga, Apayao, and Mountain Province are under the Cordillera Administrative Region. Abra has an extremely rugged terrain, with mountains and hills rising along its perimeter interior. The plains are drained by the Abra River, which flows northward from Mount Data in Mountain Province. It has a land area of 3,975.5 square kilometers, which is much bigger than that Ifugao with 2,507 square kilometers. The climate is characterized by two distinct seasons, dry from November to April and wet rest of the year. Abra used to be a part of the old Ilocos Province. In 1818, through Act 2683, the Ilocos Province was divided into two provinces, namely Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur. Abra was part of Ilocos Sur. In 1846, Abra was created as political military provinces. It remained so until the arrival of the Americans in 1899. Because of financial difficulties, the Philippine Commission annexed Abra to Ilocos Sur in 1808. But on March 9, 1917, the Philippine Assembly re-established Abra as a province. With the issuance of Executive Order No. 220 in July 1987 by the President of the Philippines, Abra became one of the provinces of CAR. The 1903 population census of the Philippines Island shows that Abra was one of the provinces, military district, and included the following 12 municipalities: Bangued, Bucay, Dolores, La Paz, Pitigan, Pilar, San Gregorio, San Jose, San Juan, San Quintin, Tayom, and Villaueja.
The fiesta is a big part of Filipino culture. To the province of Abra, fiestas must go on through good and bad times. It is a regular celebration to give thanks to the patron saint or recognize their rich culture and tradition, as well as their favorite products. Arya Abra Festival. One of the biggest festivals of Abra is the Arya Abra Festival. It is a week-long celebration coinciding with the province's foundation anniversary held annually every March 5 to 10 or at the second week of March in the capital town of Bangued. It showcases the province's history and culture through parades, cultural shows, and agro-industrial fairs. The highlights of the revelries are the Keriraki, a bamboo rafting along Calaba River, and the Tingian festivals of the tribal natives of Abra. Tingian Festival. The festival is celebrated annually during the Arya Abra Festival. It is an ethno-cultural festival featuring the rich and colorful dances, rituals, and songs of the Tingians. Ranyag Ti Abra Festival. The yearly Ranyag Ti Abra Festival is a colorful festivity of ethnic dancing showcasing the Ilocos Tingian dance, native food, and trade fair. It is celebrated during the month of March. Abranyan Kawayan Festival. Bamboo is the major industry of Abra, aside from tobacco. The festival was named Kawayan Festival, a three-day traditional celebration starting every 6th of March. It features a grand cultural parade of beauty and creative floats and handicrafts made of bamboo. There are also trade fairs, cultural presentations, balikbayan nights, and fashion shows. Sakuting dance is a much-awaited activity where dance performers are a group of men using bamboo sticks. Dapil Festival. Dapil came from the word dadapilan, an equipment used in extracting sugarcane juice. From the meaning, the festival is celebration focused on sugarcane, one of the Abra's main agricultural products. Sugarcane is manufactured into a wine called basi, vinegar, molasses called moscovado, and candies. The festival also features basketball tournaments, beauty contests, parade, and cultural shows. Sakuting Festival. Sakuting Festival is the best of Dolores, the second municipality of Abra Province, celebrated every 5th day of May. It implements programs and activities that reflect the well-preserved culture and arts, practice, tradition, and socio-economic and livelihood activities of the Dolorenians. Abranians are proud of their festivals that are visited by thousands of locals and foreign tourists. People flock to the place just to witness the colorful tribal celebration of the province. Festivals are an inherent part of Abranians, and these are their way to give thanks for their blessings and commemorate their past.
Next, we will be knowing more about the cultural practices of Abra. The first one is about childhood rituals. First one is Apu. This is practice of the Masadi tribe for the parents bring the child to the grandparents for the first time. Gifts are exchanged by the parents or immediate relative bringing the child in the other grandparents. Sometimes the grandparents give a chicken or butcher a piglet to welcome the child. Second, Libu. The baby is placed at the door to avoid bad spirit. The elder, either lakay or bakut, carry the child, raise it on the door, and make prayers. Third is Kubkubar, a welcome ritual for the baby to become a member of the family. The elders and parents and other family members prepare foods to eat after the ritual. Fourth one is Lumbus. This is a confirmation rite performed after a month for the child to gain strength while growing up. Food is served to the relatives of the family joining the ritual. The next one is courtship in marriage. The first one is Kalon or child engagement. The Kalon or child betrothal was practiced for a long time. Practices in societies have changed, however, there are still some who continue to practice Kalon even these changing times. When a boy is about 6 to 8 years old, he is matched with a girl. His parents are intermediary, visits the parents of the girl and give engagement 3 beads signifying the intentions. If the offer is accepted, the beads are tied around the waist of the girl as a sign of agreement. Second is Danon or Kalkalimusta, which means to reach. The groom and his parents are going to propose to the parents of the girl. At times, bride's family demand for gifts something like a dowry, like land, money, house, animals, fruit trees, and other. Bargaining of gifts are negotiated, then wedding is set after the agreement. This agreement is written in blood or signed by the parents of the couple and witnesses from both parties. This danon is considered as the most expensive wedding ceremony among the Maings. The third one is singlip, an engagement ritual for the adults done when the man's family visits the woman's family. The agreements will include the sabong and the pamuusok, which is the gift to the bride's family. Taduk is the appropriate dance during this occasion, and a pig is usually butchered for the meal during the planning of the marriage. The fourth one is sabong or dowry. This refers to the traditional costume that the family has observed in the past marriages of the family clan. This is mostly practiced by the well-to-do family, wherein the family of the groom offers money, piece of land, animals to the bride. Fifth is Buddha. This is the happenings after the wedding ceremony at the church. It is relatively a celebration with ethnic dances, songs, and other presentations are rendered. The couple, together with their families, relatives, and invited guests, celebrate with rituals. The sixth one is Sabit or Bitur, done when the couple dance accompanied by gangsa and other Tinggian musical instrument as way of maintaining the couple will live harmoniously with the sitters, hang money to the wedding dress of the couple. Seven is Duya. During this part of the Buddha, two elders, a male and female, will wrap the money with a cloth and they will make a chant full of advices for the couple, especially on how they will use the money. Now let's go to death and burial rites. Pagpagada, palpalubos, or pagpagada is performed the eve of a burial. Everyone gathers around the deceased and enact the rite of the palpalubos or farewell. Members of the immediate family chant their farewell words. Someone is asked to stop of the dead person who bids the living goodbye. Kilias. This is a ritual performed immediately after the interment, where the ceremony includes dancing, chanting to assuage the pain of the bereaved. This signifies the releasing the dead to the great beyond. Pabalun. This is the rite done the day after the interment, where the favorite food and things valued by the dead are placed on the top of the tomb. A bonfire is lit to signify warming the dead. Waxi, or end of grieving. 8 or 10 months after the burial, the waxi is done to put an end to the grievances of the bereaved family. Thanksgiving mass or palualu, the genuine way of thanksgiving, is done. Now let's go to justice practices. One is sapata. It means swear. This practice may be considered as a justice system, as this is observed in practice to solve problems and to prevent other problems that may arise from the problem if it remains unsolved. The real criminal will suffer the punishment in the swearing. Lupun. In order to reduce the load of the lower courts, local communities of citizens called pacification communities, Lupun Tagapamayapa, are organized to effect extrajudicial settlement of minor cases between barangay residents. In each Lupun, there is conciliation body, Pangkat Tagapakasundo. Budong or bidding, together with the institution of the village councils and assemblies, the inter-village peace pact holders or guarantors provide the element of a working political order evolved by the tribe's people themselves in the matrix of their own culture. Dapai system. The community calls for general and as attendees who among them are planning to run for election. They ensure peaceful election. Abra also has other practices. One is Layuk. state memorial celebration, it is done a year or more years after the death of a person whose state memorial is celebrated. Buyun, it means to know or to discover. This is a ritual to know the whereabouts of lost personal belongings, other tools, animals, etc., or to know the cause of an illness. One is in Laluyun or Aluyun. This is a Tingyan way of working together. It is usually done when a particular work demands a big group to finish it, like house construction. This is also practiced when a community project requires labor from community members.
The economy of Abra province. Before the Spanish colonized the Philippines, the people of Abra were engaged in agriculture, production, and trade. They used the Abra River as their means of transportation. There were the traders from Vigan and other provinces who used to trade with them. With its vast forest, Abra's economy is based on agriculture. Its major crops are rice, corn, sweet potato, and tubes. They also plant sugar cane with its juice used in the production of local wine called basi. Their commercial products include coffee, tobacco, and coconut. The extensive grass and pasture land are used for livestock production. Aside from agriculture, they made iron tools like kitchen knives, head axes, and bolo. As of 1990, there were 743 cottage industries in Abra, of which 208 are registered with the Department of Trade and Industry. 59% are engaged in bamboo and rattan craft making, both leading industries in the area. The Tingyans make cloth from the bark of certain trees, the women weave materials that they make into blankets, and they also make mats and engage in pottery. The men produce ropes, baskets, and nets.